Every man wears is the programmer of his destiny. You can never rise beyond what you say. Whatever you say is what you become. You can program and map out your life. You can map out a life plan using your words. You can program your life using words.
Your
words are powerful. And there is a battle in the realm of the spirit. It is not a battle of flesh. In the realm of the spirit, we don't fight with the flesh. In the realm of the spirit, we fight with words. The Bible says in the book of Isaiah, the chapter 41 verses 21. The Lord was asking us to come with our evidence. The Lord was saying we should present our case.
Yes.
Words are powerful, and then whatever you communicate determine your destiny. The Bible says where the word of the king is, there is power. Where the word of the king is, there is power.
Amen.
Which means the king don't need to be there for there to be power. It is the word of the king that brings power.
You
where the word of the king is, there is power. And then tonight, somebody must learn how to use his words. You are going to fight a battle using your words. Hebrews 13 verses 15. Through Jesus, therefore, let us continually offer to God a sacrifice. Meanwhile, the Philistine with his shield bearer in front of him kept coming closer to David. He looked David over and saw that he was only a boy, ruddy and handsome, and he despised him. He said to David, am I a dog that you come at me with sticks? And the Philistine cursed David by his gods. If you read this scripture, you would discover that it was a battle of words. The war was a war of words. It was beyond the physical engagement. It was beyond the physical skill of David throwing a stone. The Bible said Goliath cursed David first. And when Goliath cursed David, David also cursed Goliath. So it was a battle of words even before they come to the physical battle.
What?
Before David cursed Goliath, David told Saul, the same God who deliver the lion in the wilderness, that delivered the wild beast, would deliver the Philistine in my hands. Which means David was battling with words. It was a programming. David was programming the battle before he even walked into the battlefield. So it was not just a physical engagement of David, but before the physical engagement, David had already programmed the battle using his words. So the Bible said the words David spoke was what manifest in the battlefield. So before David went to the battlefield, he knew that he would kill the Philistine. He knew that he will overcome the Philistine. He knows who God was. He knew what God had done before. He knew what God had delivered him from before. So David was using the testimonies of yesterday against Goliath today. He knows that if God can deliver the lion in his hands, he can deliver the Philistine. That is why today the battle is not a physical battle. It is a battle of words. And you need to put God's reputation at risk by reminding him of the wonders he did yesterday. You know, whenever you stand in front of God and you begin to declare of the things he done yesterday, you are programming and you are forcing God to manifest. So you have to learn how to speak. Come in the presence of God with testimonies.
Yeah.
The Bible says in the book of Revelation, the chapter 12, verses 11, they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony. So David overcame Goliath not because he was skillful, not because he was intelligent, no. Not because he could throw, no. But by the word of his testimony. The Bible says in the book of Ecclesiastes, the chapter 11, verses 3, if clouds are full of water, they pour rain upon the earth. Whether a tree falls to the south or to the north, in that place where it fails, there will it lie. The Bible says if the clouds be full of rain, they empty themselves. Which means whatever words that you have been speaking, they are gathering evidence against the enemy in the realm of the spirit. Whatever you say is building evidence against yourself and even the enemy in the realm of the spirit. You know, I was watching one man of God who gave a story of how one lady had an accident and then had fractures more than 20 times, 20 different parts of her body. She has fractures. The lady told God that she wanted to die. The doctors told her that even if she survived, she cannot walk, she can do nothing on her own. Looking at the damage that was caused through that accident. So the lady says she wanted to die. When the lady said that on the hospital bed, the lady slept off. And in a dream, an angel of the Lord came to the lady and told the lady, if you want to die as suggested and as requested, you have to start speaking negative words and you have to start prophesying death until your words of death overcome your words of life. You cannot die. Because you have been one of the people that have prophesied life over your life in the past years. Every day you are prophesying life. Every day you are saying you cannot die. So we cannot kill you. Even if you want to die, we cannot take your soul. Because you have gathered a lot of evidence in the realm of the spirit against even your own wish. So even if you want to die, you cannot die. Because it is not possible. You have to start confessing death all over again. Immediately the lady heard the angel said that she recovered from the dream and realized that she was healed. From the crown of her head to the soles of her feet, every part of her body was made whole. The words that the lady spoke, they gathered clouds. And as they formed the clouds, when it was full, it emptied itself. So the battle that you are coming to fight tonight is a battle of words. It's a battle of evidence. Some of you have to remind God what he has done in your life, even when you were 1 year old. What he has done in your life when you were 5 years old. Some of you have to gather evidence. You have to begin to prophesy. You have to prophesy life, even against the enemy ahead of time. There is no prophet who can prophesy over your life and it will work like you yourself. You are the best prophet God has ever given yourself. So every word you speak is what will speak for you in the future. Every word you speak is what will manifest later. So that is why tonight you need to understand that David didn't just fight Goliath with just a stone and then a sling, but David fought him with words. It was a battle of words, because David committed his God and Goliath too committed his God. The Bible says, and Goliath cursed David with his curse. And then David too cursed Goliath with his God. So it was now a battle of God, not just a battle of men. So it was a battle of God. The testimony you give about your God determines how he manifests in your life. Whatever you say about him will force him to manifest in your life. If you see your God as a God of miracles, he begins to perform miracles in your life. If you see him as a God who delivers, he will deliver you. God manifests himself to us according to our level of knowledge, not according to his level of knowledge. He manifests himself in power, in deliverance, in wisdom, in prophecy, in healing, according to the level we know him, not at his level. Because every new level determines how you host God. Whenever you climb a new level, you meet God at that dimension. Whenever you decided to go for a higher dimension in the realm of the spirit, that is where you meet God, at a higher dimension. And you never know that God has ever operated in that dimension before. But God is in that dimension. He's just waiting for you to meet him there. Now, there were many soldiers in the land of Israel, but the Bible says all of them were gathered. They have trained. They were skillful. They were trained and skillful soldiers. But yet, they couldn't stand before Goliath. Why? Because they didn't know. They have no track record of what God has ever done in the life of Israel. They were not having a track record of what God can do, what God have already done. Even before they were born, in the life of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, they never knew where they were coming from. As a result of that, it limited them. What limits men in battle is not strength. What limits men in battle is ignorance. And then that is what you need to understand, that tonight, what you need to excel in the battle of words is knowledge. What you need to excel in the battle of this dimension that you are coming to fight is the knowledge of the scriptures. Whatever you say, it's all will happen. The Bible says, when a tree falls to the south or the north, where it falls, that is where it will lie. So if you prophesy death, you will experience death. If you prophesy life, you will experience life. David said, that same God that delivered, he was committing God. How many of you have a testimony of what God have done in your life? That testimony is what will give you a leverage tonight. I know there are some people here, you are having issues. You have troubles in your life. But listen to me. Some of you, you may say you don't have a testimony, but whatever you are going through tonight is a testimony. The Lord is just preparing you for tomorrow. Whatever you are going through tonight is a testimony, and that testimony, the Lord is preparing it against the enemy tomorrow. So one day you will say, that same God that delivered me from poverty this night will do it in my life again. That same God that delivered me from death tonight will deliver you from death again and again and again. So whatever you are going through is even your testimony. You just need to understand the timings and the seasons of God. How many of you knows that champions are not made at the ring. The champions are recognized at the ring. Before you become a champion, it is shown in your daily activities every day. So your daily activities is what determine whether you are a champion or not. No one becomes a champion at the ring. No, it is not possible for you to enter a ring and become a champion. Before you enter the ring, you have already become a champion at the house. So before David entered the battlefield, he was already a champion, because David knew who his God was. He knew what God had done for him. He was having a track record of God. We are not serving a dead God. We are serving a living God, a God who has done it before. He will do it again. This thing we speak every day is not to stir into your emotion. We are not trying to manage you so that your day of death will reach. We are not psychologists. But whatever that is said from this pulpit is true, and it is clear. It is the reality. God is alive. Jesus is alive. And Jesus is with you. Whatever he delivered you from yesterday, he will do it today again. Your past testimony, it's an evidence against the enemy today that the Lord didn't leave you when you were a child, so he will never leave you today. That when the enemy came around, the Lord showed up. If he showed up yesterday, he will show up today again. The God we serve, there is no deadline that is so short for him to meet. Even if you give God 1 second, he will still show up. There's no deadline that God cannot meet. Give me a deadline that God cannot meet. It is possible to sleep tonight as nobody and wake up and the whole Accra is talking about you. Because when God decides to do it, he don't need to consult anybody. He just do it without consulting any man. It is possible to sleep with that hope and wake up and become a hope for many people. You will sleep with that any hope in your life, in the life of your family, and the next day you are a hope for millions of people. Because when God is coming to do it, he don't need strength to do it. No, one word from God. The Bible said, let there be light, and there was light. Go to darkness and say, let there be light, and see if there will be light. No, you know, the law of energy states that energy cannot be created or destroyed. Energy can only be transferred from one state to another state. So when the Lord said, let there be light, and there was light, it was the voice of God. It is sound energy. So as the Lord spoke, let there be light, that voice turned to light. Light was not needed to be created, but his voice was having that spiritual energy to turn to light. So when God speaks over your life, he don't need to take days to do it. No, tonight, God is not going to say 3 days from now. It's going to be now. He is the God of now.
Amen.
Our God don't show tomorrow. He does not show tomorrow next. He don't show 7 days later. When he is showing, he will show now.
Amen.
Whatever you are passing through, whatever the problem is, I prophesy now.
Yes,
let that problem disappear.
Yes, Lord.
Let that problem disappear.
Yes, Lord.
Let that problem disappear.
In Jesus' name.
Let that problem disappear.
In Jesus' name.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let that problem disappear.
In Jesus' name.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Take your seat, somebody. Our God is a God of now. What have you been saying over your life? What evidence have you gathered in the realm of the spirit? What weight is your words carrying in the realm of the spirit? You know, there are some people, they are confusing God and confusing angels. People like this, God himself don't know what to do when they are speaking. Because today you say you are poor, the next day you say you are rich, the next day you say you are this. So even your angel is confused. Your angel don't know your real identity. Today you are born again, the next day you are not born again. So angels are so confused about even your real identity. But you need to gather evidence in the realm of the spirit to understand it is impossible for the devil to take you by surprise. It is impossible for any situation to just take you like that, because the evidence that you have gathered in the realm of the spirit using your words is so much that until the devil take you by surprise, he will need to undo those evidence. And those evidence, no devil can do it except you yourself. The Bible says our mouth is a ready pen writer. Whatever we say is what is written down. The Bible says in the book of Judges, an angel of the Lord appeared to Gideon. Gideon was afraid. And the angel of the Lord addressed Gideon as a mighty man of valor. And Gideon said, you are addressing me as a mighty man of valor. But see what is happening in our family. See what is happening in Israel. We have become slaves, and you are addressing me as a mighty man of valor. Stop addressing me with those names. And the angel of the Lord said, you are a mighty man of valor. And Gideon said, we have heard of how God have delivered our fathers from the hands of the enemy. We have heard of the mighty things and the terrible things God have done. We have heard of his strong hand against the Philistines, against the Amalekites, against the Ammonites. We have heard of what God have done against the enemy during the days of our fathers. Where is that same God? And I was shocked by the reply of the angel of the Lord. He said, Gideon, go in this thy might. Go in this thy might. What was the might? The might was not physical energy. It was not the stature of Gideon. It was not the intelligence of Gideon. But the fact that you know that God have delivered your forefathers before, he can do it. That same God that delivered your forefather will do it in your life. That same God that set your forefathers free will set you free. So the Bible said, and Gideon gathered that strength, and then he stood up and mobilized the army of Israel. And only a handful of them, the Lord told Gideon, reduce them. Gideon have gathered a number of them, and the Lord said, cut the number down. He cut them, and the Lord said, cut it again. He cut it, the Lord said, cut it for the third time. Leave it like this. Because God wanted to remind Gideon and then the Israelites that I was the God who delivered them. I will do it again. I delivered them when they didn't know how to use a sword. When God was delivering the people from Egypt, they never know how to use a sword or a javelin. No, he delivered them with his hand. With his mighty hand, he set them free. That same God that set Abraham, Isaac, Jacob free. That same God that was with them, that same God is coming tonight.
Yes, Lord.
And somebody is about to be set free.
Amen.
Your troubles is about to leave you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The Bible said, Gideon delivered the people. He set them free. And he became a man of his generation because of knowledge. The angel said, I came to you because of the knowledge you are having. You know that God have set them free before. He will do it. Whenever God perform a miracle in your neighborhood, he is there. If there is somebody close to you and that person is a testimony, he's an evident of what God can do or what God have done, you are next. It's an evident that God is about to do it. That was Gideon. An angel make that reference to. If John the Baptist is greater than Gideon, and the angel said, thou mighty man of valor, because of the small knowledge Gideon was having, you who is born of Christ in the kingdom of God, you have been translated from the kingdom of darkness into the kingdom of his dear son, the kingdom of light. You have been made whole. You have been set apart. You are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, God's own special one. You are the apple of God's eye. You are a peculiar nation, which means God have made provision for you, which means the level of knowledge you are operating with, you're supposed to command better results than Elijah, better results than Elisha, better results than Moses, better results than Gideon. The Lord have sent me tonight to tell you that the same God that did it for Gideon, he will do it for you.
Amen.
That God that did it for Moses will do
Amen.
It for you. That God that did it for David will do it for
Amen.
You. God is about to do something in your life.
Yes.
Something big is about to happen. In the name of Jesus.
Have you ever made Jesus the Lord and Savior of your life? If not, pray this prayer and start a new life in Christ. Dear God, I come to you in the name of Jesus. I admit that I am not right with you, and I want to be right with you. I ask you to forgive me of all my sins. The Bible says if I confess with my mouth that Jesus is Lord and believe in my heart that God raised him from the dead, I will be saved. I believe with my heart and I confess with my mouth that Jesus is the Lord and Savior of my life. Thank you for saving me in Jesus' name, I pray. Amen. Now that you are born again, you can worship with any Stars of Heaven church close to you or any Bible-believing church. Locate Stars of Heaven Ministries in Bolgatanga on top of the Ghana News Agency building. Sundays, first service, from 7:30 a.m. to 9:30 a.m. Second service, from 10 a.m. to 12 p.m. And evening services from 3 p.m. to 5 p.m. Midweek services on Wednesdays from 5 p.m. to 7 p.m. Tuesdays for counseling from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. For more inquiries, contact the numbers on your screen. Thank you.